Keith Richards and Mick Jagger despise one other and cannot bear each other. The Rolling Stones bring in the kind of money that neither Mick Jagger nor Keith Richards could make on their own, according to a stunning new Stones memoir. This is the only reason why Mick Jagger and Keith Richards continue to play together. Rock journalist Rich Cohen states in his freewheeling memoir of life on the road with the Rolling Stones that the Glimmer twins became more pessimistic toward one other in the 1980s. Cohen's memoir is titled The Sun and the Moon and the Rolling Stones. However, the book that really infuriated Jagger was Richards' autobiography, which is now considered to be legendary and was published in October of 2010. During the time when Jagger was driving up to Richards' house in Connecticut to read a galley of the book before it was published, Cohen says that Jagger was the first person to learn about the controversial content included within the book. Richards disclosed that the band's nickname for Jagger was Her Majesty or Whiny, Needy Brenda. The frontman was taken aback by what he read from Richards. According to Richards, bandmates would frequently make cryptic references to that scumbag Brenda while Jagger was present in the room, with Jagger being completely unaware of what was going on. Over the course of the 1980s, the guitarist stated that the singer had grown intolerable, and he even made fun of Jagger's diminutive todger. The album that Jagger released under his own name in 2003 was referred to as Dogs in the Doorway by Richards, who was critical of the quality of Jagger's solo productions. On the first day of the album's release, just 954 copies were sold through sales. The news that Jagger had accepted a knighthood in 2003 caused Richards to go fuck King berserk. This was a bitter reminder of the fact that in 1967, police officers acting on a tip-off had detained both Jagger and Richards for using narcotics during a party that was held at Richards' country property in England. During that time period, Richards stated that Jagger was going to be joining the same establishment that did their very best to throw us in jail and kill us. This spicy biography went on to sell more than a million copies, according to Cohen, who claims that Jagger begged Richards to remove some of the most embarrassing information from Life. Richards, however, refused to do so. The following is a paraphrase of what Jagger said to Cohen about his thoughts on the book. Imagine that whatever Keith says he says is accurate. Think about what a business partner would say about such items. Consider the possibility that your partner is hooked to drugs. There will be occasions when you have a significant meeting, but he will not show up. It's also possible that he is caught on the eve of a trip around the world. What are your thoughts on his complaints in the event that this were to occur?